my Maserati. Baby, hop in my Maserati. I said, hop in my Maserati. Hop in my Maserati.
Girl, I wanna see you throw down.
Yeah, say me, I love the way you bend body. Hop in my Maserati. Baby, hop in my Maserati.
And I just wanna see you ride.
Hi honeys, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you are new here, my name is Ndasa, and if you are a returning subscriber, thank you so much for coming back to share your girl love. Your presence here is highly appreciated. So in today's video, I will be doing a book review and a couple of books that I've read throughout the year. We are in August 2020. Okay, so I also just thought I mentioned that individuality is quite important, so I am entitled to my opinion on the book, and if you have read the book and you probably have a different viewpoint on it, let me know what you thought of the book. I could learn from you, you could learn from me. And if you have not read the book and the title does look interesting, please do get the book and read. Tell me what you thought about it. Don't let my final judgment on the book cloud your overall judgment of the book as well. Before I start with my first book, let me just share with you guys that I buy most of my books from Uncle Spike's Book Exchange, which is a bookshop situated in Osborne Platz, Windhoek, in Tall Street, right opposite Natchez. They sell a wide range of books there, secondhand books that are very affordable. These prices can be as low as $2 Namibian. Sometimes they have a stack of books packed together for $10 Namibian. They're very affordable, and so you can exchange some of your old books there to get new books. They don't give you money in exchange, but rather you earn points that you could use to buy other books. This is definitely one of my favorite places in the whole wide world. Like, or I think you should really check it out if you're planning on getting yourself a book, or if you plan on starting or developing your reading culture. Uncle Spike's is definitely the place. So the first book that I will be talking about is Rich Dad's Guide to Investing, which is a book by Robert Kiyosaki, the man behind Rich Dad, Poor Dad. In this book, he just talks about what the rich do differently from the poor and the middle class. He also talks about the three E's, which I think stood out for me in the book. The first being education, the second being experience, and the third being excessive cash. So under education, Robert just states that you need to understand financial literacy before you can dive into it. You need to understand how business works. You need to understand how the laws of investing works. You need to understand how to read your financial statements. You have to take an online course to do that. If you have to sit with people that know, that are already experts in the field, do that. By all means, just try to expand on your education, expand on what you already know in that specific field. Robert states that investing only becomes risky when you don't understand what you're doing. So before you invest in Forex, also, this is now on a different note, before you invest in Forex, before you invest in Bitcoin, before you do all this online trading and things, understand what you're doing. Invest in knowing. Knowledge is power, guys. Stop the tendency of giving your money hoping that somebody else can make you the money when you don't even understand the basic principalities of the whole thing. And then the second E being experience, where he puts emphasis on perseverance and how the rich don't easily give up, that they are continuously trying to perfect their skill, their expertise, or the services that they offer in whatever field of business that they're in. So when you keep failing, learn from your mistakes and put mechanisms in place on how you can perfect it the next time. It's through those failing trials that you gain experience and perfect at your art and your skill. It's through trying again that you become a good investor. Okay, and then the last E being excessive cash, where he just states that the rich ensure that they have multiple sources of income to mitigate their expenses with these different sources of incomes that they have. Robert also talks about other things in the book which I won't be detailing. He talks about the 90-10 rule, the good investor versus the bad investor. He talks about the different kind of investors that we have. He basically gives you the technicalities of investing. It isn't a guarantee that once you read this book you will become a good investor, but it's more like a guide on how to become a good investor. So far what I've learned from it is just that not everybody can become an investor, because there are certain investments that only the rich can invest in, because you need to be accredited. So yeah, I don't think it's the most practical book for beginners to start with, or like for those that want to start investing from scratch. Let me not take away from Robert Kiyosaki. I still think he is one of the very best in the field of investments, business, and financial literacy. So if you do want to get yourself this book, I got it from Uncle Spice for 160 Namibian dollars. I have not finished reading it. It's a book that you continuously need to come back to. So I am so excited to show you guys the next book that I will be reviewing, which is City of Girls by Elizabeth Gilbert. I genuinely loved reading this book. So this is a fictional book, and the protagonist of the story being Vivian Morris, an elderly lady looking back at her 19-year-old self and all the challenges that she's been through. So it's in the summer of 1940 where Vivian Morris arrives in New York with her suitcase and her sewing machine, because she was very passionate about sewing. Fast forward a few years, she has a shop where she's selling bridal gowns, and she's excelling at it. She tried to find a niche that made her different from all the other boutiques that were around by recreating vintage looks. I really love how Elizabeth portraying womanhood in an era where their beliefs, where their dreams, where their movement and everything else about themselves was being governed. There was good imagery in the book. I love the emotional honesty in the book. I loved the expressiveness in the book. I loved the humor. I loved the setting. I loved how the characters were combined and how they were fictional. I think it was quite educational. I got it from CNA for 250 Namibian dollars, but I also saw it in Uncle Spike's. I'm not too sure of the price at Uncle Spike's, but I can guarantee you that it's way, way cheaper. Getting into the third book that I will be reviewing is Does My Bum Look Big in This by Arabella Wire. Okay, let me just keep it at Arabella because I really have a hard time pronouncing her surname. This book is written in a form of a diary of a 33-year-old woman who is insecure about her body, wishes she had firmer boobs, smaller butt, a smaller waist. So the protagonist of the story is Jacqueline, who just talks about how she's insecure about certain aspects of her body, like I'd mentioned earlier. I think it was an indication that body insecurities is something that so many other people are fighting within themselves, or those that are not, it's just because they have learned how to become comfortable within their own being. And I think that's the essence in it. So that brings me to the point that stop playing perfectionist people's bodies. Stop trying to perfect what you deem as a flaw on somebody else's body. Like, people have seen these things on themselves already. There is no need, absolutely no need, for you to come and give your 2 cents on what you think is not right because of how I am created. Do it, please. Stop doing things like that. It's not nice. Don't say something to someone that they cannot change within 15 minutes. If you're going to talk about my hair, fixing my hair or something, that is okay. But so no, getting back into the book, I got this book from Uncle Spike's for 30 Namibian dollars, and all in all, for me it was draining, but I think it would be good for other people to read it just to see that you're not going through life alone or through body insecurities alone. So the next book that I will be talking about is How Much Is Enough? Maximizing Wealth and Well-being. This book has 3 different authors. So the authors are showing the reader how happiness and money can intersect. They're giving you guides on how to invest. Also, they're giving you guides on how to effectively communicate, how to accumulate generational wealth that you could pass over to your children. I love the holistic combination in psychology, sociology, financial literacy, happiness, emotional, physical, mental well-being. The book was also an indication that intelligence will not guarantee you success, but then you need to learn how to plan, how to set goals, how to prioritize certain values. So I got this book from Uncle Spike for 120 Namibian dollars. For me, it's more like Robert Kiyosaki's guide to investing. It's not a book that you read one time and you drop it or you give it away. It's a book that you continuously need to come back to read, understand the message that it's trying to convey. So the next book that I will be reviewing is Trevor Noah's Born a Crime, a book that I really enjoyed reading. I could not stop laughing, although at times I was really angry with the system. I was angry with how the violence that was portrayed in the book, but I love that it was a reflection of his life and how honest he was about it. So Trevor talks about his life as a biracial child, growing up in the post-apartheid era in South Africa, a period where interracial marriage or sex was not allowed. And so he also shows a very humorous approach to the different challenges he went through with his mother. There are certain things that he was not allowed to do, for instance, moving around or going out. Even being disciplined as a child by his grandmother was something that she found wrong, because she felt she was committing a crime or she was doing something wrong simply because he was white, or because his skin tone was different from everybody else. And being white in that era was like, what? It was like, bruh, the whites were superior over the blacks. And so he just really talks about all those different things that he went through as a child. And I love the humorous approach that he used, because despite the challenges that he went through, there were really no elements of self-pity for me, where he would look down on himself or wish that he was something else or hope that he was in a better situation. Like, there was none of that. For anybody who loves a good story, Trevor Noah's Born a Crime is definitely a must read. You should. So the next book that I will be talking about is one by Elizabeth Gilbert, which is Eat, Pray, Love. I almost said City of Girls. Anyway, it is Eat, Pray, Love. In this book, Elizabeth just talks about her personal journey to self-discovery, like a four-year journey where she just travels around Italy, India, Indonesia, in attempt to recover from the heroine character that tried to play in her past life, recover from her failed marriage. And so, like, with the Eat, she talks about how she's been trying out different kind of food at different kinds of restaurants in different countries, and just how trying out those different delicacies is bringing some sort of self-satisfaction to her life, you know. And then she also talks about praying, where she just engaged in meditation at different ashrams, different yogis as well, and just how she learned how to silence her mind. It's the conflicting thoughts that she has been fighting, what they have been holding her back from finding her true self. With love, I don't really think she's entirely portraying it in the sense of a romantic relationship, but rather how she fell in love with different architecture, the different people she's meeting at the different ashrams where she's meditating, the different yogis, the different it was a beautiful read. I bought this book for $55 Namibian from Uncle Spike's bookshop. So the next book that I will be talking about is one that makes me realize I don't have my life in order right now, and it's simply because this book. I don't even want to have my face next to this book because it makes me feel so bad. Like, I need to wipe away my mouth with it, but I'm just not serious about getting the paper that comes from reading this book.
Like, I need motivation, guys. I don't know.
And that's the reason why I am bringing it here. And I can make a pinky promise. Like, please comment with your pinky promise that we are going to get this paper together and we're going to read this book and pass. And once you get the paper, we enroll with NamDrive Driving Academy, which is a driving school in Windhoek and the North. Okay, the North is broader because they have branches in Ondangwa, in Owediva, in Oshakati. And yeah, and I really love how dedicated they are. I mean, ensuring that their students make it. Like, let me show you. Sure, what
you know, go in person. Love the way you did dance, girl. I am a image. Why they can love fight? Mommy, be cool. Let's hop in my Maserati. Baby, hop in my Maserati. I said, hop in my Maserati.
So yeah, that is why I am suggesting NamDrive. With them, you are guaranteed to pass. And I love that they have packages that can cater to your specific need. Beginner, intermediate, pro as well. They have it all. Put together a paper, guys. Now I'm coming back and I'm like,
hi, hello, like, I'm practicing for that day. Like, I'm gonna pose like this. And I'm gonna bring it back like this, like.
Call NamDrive. The number is down here on the screen. Visit their Instagram page, which is NamDrive. On Facebook, they're on Twitter. I have finally come to the end of the video. Don't forget to give me a massive thumbs up if you did like the video. Leave me a comment and let me know what you thought of the book review. If you have not read a book this year, I'm challenging you to pick up at least one book from Uncle Spike's bookshop. and read, because knowledge is power. With that, from me, Ndafa, thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you in my next video.
Subscribe. Don't forget to subscribe.